So in the last episode, we were able to set up our Redux store. And in this episode, I want us to try and fetch our data from our backend API using create async dunk. And to do that, we need to have our backend running. So open your terminal and then cd into backend and run your backend using nodemon. And make sure it's saying server running on port 5000. And from now on, I'll be needing you to have your backend running so that we can be able to fetch data from that backend API and make use of it on our frontend. So let's just get started with create async dunk. I'll minimize this. And what you need to do is to import create async dunk from Redux toolkit. So right here, I'll simply import create async dunk. And then right here, we can create an action creator that will make use of create async dunk. So right here, I'll say export const products fetch. So this is the name that I'm giving to this action creator, and we'll set this to be equal to create async dunk. We call create async dunk like this, and it will accept three parameters. The first parameter is an action type. The second one is payload creator, which will be simply a function. And the last one is usually the options. But in this case, we'll just use the first parameter and the second parameter. So the first parameter is an action type. How I like to create the action type is by using the name of our slice and the products fetch right here, which is our action creator. So the first thing is products, which is the name of our slice, stroke, the name of our action creator, which is products fetch. Now, this is the first parameter, which is an action type. And then the second parameter is a function that will create our payload. It's called a payload creator. So right here, I can just have a function. And from this function, we can be able to fetch the data using Axios. In the last episode, I told you to install Axios, and we can be able to import it just like this. So I'll import Axios from Axios. And now right here, I can be able to use axios.get. And right here, I'm supposed to pass in the endpoint. So what I will do, I'll go to my app and I'll copy this particular link. I'll come back and paste it here. And I'll change 3000 to 5000 since our server is running on localhost 5000. And for us to hit the endpoint, we need to add stroke products. And now this will be an async action. It will take some time to process, so we can await it. So I'll say await. And whenever we use await, we need to wrap our function here with async. So right here, I'll say async await. Whatever we'll get here is a response, and we can store that response in a constant. So I'll say const response will be equal to await axios.get, and then we get our products. Now, as I told you, this is a payload creator, so we need to return something from this particular function. And what we will return is response.data. So I'll say response.data. Now, to safely load the data, what I like to do is to include a question mark right there. So this won't throw an error in case we don't have any property called data in our response. And this is all we need to do to fetch the data from our endpoint. So we have this type as the first parameter and this async call as our second parameter. And this will now generate three other action types automatically. So we'll have products, stroke products fetch, stroke pending, we'll have stroke fulfilled, we'll have stroke rejected, and we can be able to handle those actions and update our state at our reducers. So in create slice right here, we had added the name of the slice, we had added initial state, which is this, and we had added reducers. Now to handle the action types, which will be generated right here, we will need to add another property right here called extra reducers. So I'll add extra reducers right here. I use a full colon and an object. Now, the difference between reducers here and extra reducers here is that these reducers will generate action creator and handle the state for those action creators in here. But this one will not generate action creators. It will only handle the action types. So use extra reducers whenever you have an action creator already defined outside our create slice. So we have our action creator right here, so we don't need to create another one, and therefore we will handle the types in here. And if you want to generate an action creator plus handle the state for that action creator, that is when you will use reducers, and we'll see that one later on when we get to handling the state for our cart. But for now, we are interested to handle the types for our products fetch. So how you can handle the types or how you can access them is using a square bracket and then the name of our action creator right there, and we say dot pending. So this will be automatically be generated for us, and we can access it like this. And then right here we'll use a full colon, and we will have a function here which have access to the state, and that state is this one, and it will also have access to action. And we can do something like this, and we can update the state right here. So if we have pending, what we would like to do is to update the status. And Redux toolkit is awesome because right here we can update the state like this. We can say state dot status, and we set this to be pending. Now look, this is like mutating the state. And in our old Redux way of doing things, we are not supposed to do this. We are like supposed to spread the state and then update the status property. But now in Redux toolkit, we can do this. It's like we are mutating the state. But in real sense, we are not mutating the state because Redux toolkit is using a library called IMA. So you can check this one out. It's using a library called IMA to update the state in an immutable way. So take note of that. And then we'll have two more, fulfilled and rejected. So right here, I'll duplicate this two more time, and I'll use a comma here, and I'll use a comma here. So right here we can have fulfilled, and we can be able to update our status to success whenever we have fulfilled. So I can say success, and now whatever was returned right here when it's successful is an array of our products from the back end, and we can be able to update the items, the state of our items using those products. And I told you this is a payload creator, therefore we'll have the data in our payload, and we can access it like this. We can say state dot items will be equal to action dot payload, and that will be it. Now let me remove this comment. I think it's just making my code messy, but just make a note of that. Okay, now right here we'll have rejected, so I'll say rejected. So if our process right here fails, a rejected will be automatically be created for us, and we can handle it right here. So we can say if it's rejected, then the status here will be rejected. Rejected, just like that. And this is how we actually fetch data using create async dunk. Now let's go to index.js because we need to dispatch this particular action creator. So right here we can be able to say something like store dot dispatch, and then we call that particular action creator, which is products fetch. So I'll click this and it will be auto imported right there, but I also need to call it like this. Now this will dispatch our action creator, and create async dunk will do its thing to fetch the data return the data in our action as payload, and we'll be able to handle it right here. Now let's see what we have in our Redux DevTools. So I'll go to the application. I'll just refresh just to make sure that our app is running and have been refreshed, and then I'll click on Redux DevTools. And now from Redux DevTools, you can see we have the status here changing from pending to success, which is nice. So when we have pending, you can display a loader or a spinner, and once you are done, you can display maybe a success, or you can just map through the data and show them on the screen. So right here we have our items, array of items, which is coming from our backend. And when we click on the first option here, you can see initially the status changed from null to pending, and then from here it changed from pending to success. So we are successfully fetching the data using create async bank, which is awesome. Now when I come to action here, you can see this is what was generated for us: products stroke products fetch stroke fulfilled. And when we come to this, we can see products stroke products fetch stroke pending. Now let's see if we can get a rejected. What I will do, I'll simply try to access an invalid endpoint. So I'll add an S, save that file, and then I'll come back here and we will refresh this. And now let me click Redux DevTools. And now look, instead of success, we have rejected. And in our state, our items are empty, so we are not getting anything. But the status is rejected because an error occurred when trying to fetch the data. So this is so cool. So we see we are getting pending, fulfilled, and rejected. I'll remove that and save. Now I want to show you another thing. What if you want to like pass an ID right here to fetch a specific product? Maybe you want to fetch the product using an ID. So right here we can accept several parameters. And for this, let me just come back right here and go to the documentation of create async dunk. So if you want this documentation, I'll leave a link at the description section below. Now when I scroll right here, you can see this is the explanation of how you can use it, but I'm interested with parameters. So you can see we have the first parameter is type. We have pending, fulfilled, and rejected, which will be generated to the additional Redux action. And then we have the second parameter is payload creator, and this payload creator will accept the first parameter as an argument, which you can use to like fetch a specific product. So you can pass an ID, and if you want to pass more, you need to pass them in an object because this accepts a single value. So what I mean right here, you can be able to pass an ID, and I can default this to null since we don't have an ID. And you can now be able to use that ID to fetch a specific product right here, okay? And this is usually a single value for the argument. So if you have more argument, maybe you want to post something to the backend, let's say a to-do which have a name and an ID and more, you'll need to pass it as an object. So you'll need to do something like this. Whenever you are dispatching that particular action creator, you'll pass the properties as an object. And then what I'm interested in is the second parameter. So this is the first parameter, and the second parameter is Dunk API. And this Dunk API have access to dispatch in case you want to dispatch something from our function here. And it have access to get state in case you want to use the state from the store. And it have extras, it have request ID, it have signal, and it have rejected with value. Now this is what I want to show you: rejected with value. And this rejected with value, you can use it to customize your error at our call. So what I'll do, I'll come right here and click on handling dunk errors. And when I click on that, you'll see that you can accept the user data as the first parameter. And then we have rejected with values being destructured from our Dunk API. So instead of having Dunk API, we can destructure rejected with value right here. So I'll highlight this and paste it like that. And we can be able to customize this particular call here. We can wrap it with a try, and I'll highlight this, move it right there, and now right here we can have catch, and we have access to the error object. And right here we can be able to use this rejected with value to return some payload data when an error occurs. So let me show you. We can return like this. I will just copy that actually. So in case we have an error here, we can be able to customize our error using rejected with value, and we can pass an error message, maybe an error that is coming from our backend API like this, error.response.data, and we can be able to access that error in our action payload. So right here we can say maybe let state dot let me just access the items. This is an example, or rather we can just add a property for the error. Let me add the error like that and set it to, let me set it to null to start with, and then right here we can have state dot error, and we can update it using action dot payload. Now let me just explain this. If we have an error, you can be able to customize it like this, and you can pass your own response right here, and you can be able to add it to state or do something with it. Okay, let's include an error here. We access an endpoint that does not exist. I save that. I come back right here, and error is not defined, so this is supposed to be error.response.data. I save that. I come back. I refresh this. And now when we try to check our Redux DevTools, you'll see that at our products we have rejected, and now we can be able to update our error using the payload. And this error is returning like a HTML code because we didn't properly handle the error from our backend. So right here you can pass a message just as an illustration, an error occurred. I save that, and let me refresh. Now you can see whatever we are getting at our error here is an error occurred. So the reason I'm showing you this is in case you want to customize the error which you are getting, and you want to add it to the payload and maybe do something with it, maybe update the state or anything. So in my case, I won't need to be doing this, so I'll just remove everything that we have added recently. And I also wanted to show you how you can pass like data right here and use it to fetch your data, or maybe to create a resource at our backend. So this is the simplified version of our code, and I just wanted to show you that extra step. Now this is it. That is all about the create async dunk. Maybe there is more from the documentation and you can always check it out, but I think that is good enough. And I want to show you something cool. Okay, if I come to Redux Toolkit right here, now this is like the home page. I click on get started. You'll notice that to get the documentation of create async dunk is a bit tricky from here. Okay, so that means that async dunk is somehow being placed behind the hood, and the recent way of fetching data in Redux Toolkit is RTK query. Okay, so this is now like a new way for fetching data in Redux Toolkit. And now when I click on RTK query or Redux Toolkit query and scroll right here, you'll see that we have a create async dunk right here. RTK query is built on top of Redux Toolkit core, and it leverages the APIs like create slice and create async dunk. So RTK query is built on top of create slice and on top of create async dunk. And when you click on create async dunk right here is when you get to that particular documentation. And therefore, what I'll do is that in the next video, I'll have to show you how to use RTK query to fetch data from an API, because now this is now like the new way of doing it. And I think it's necessary that I include it in this particular course. I know most of you wanted to know about the create async dunk. You can still use it, but you should gradually now transition to RTK query if you are using Redux toolkit. And you can see it have some caching solutions and some cool other stuff that we'll be able to see in the next episode. So in the next episode, I'll show you how you can use RTK query to fetch data in our Redux application. So that is it for this video. I know it was a bit long, but thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.